Join the Greater Refuge Temple every Sunday morning for Sunday morning worship.
This world will not end by COVID-19.
I wish I had a church in here.
Don't let anyone cause you to lose faith in God.
And from the waters, he lifted me.
His mercy is everlasting. His truth endures to all generations.
You would have been in a nut house someplace trying to keep up with that. Thank God you got him.
Free in the Holy Spirit, enjoying the greatest freedom of all. The Lord has been good.
Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I praise and thank God for the doors that God closed just as well as the doors that God has opened.
11 a.m. Streaming live from Facebook. Catch us on YouTube, greaterrefugetemple.org.
Oh God, the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, that same God who is immutable, unchangeable, he cannot change. Heard the word of the prophet, and the fire of God fell.
There's some of us in here that realize that if it had not been for the Lord.
Remember, those who pray can expect a miracle. Bishop Charles E. Wright, Senior Pastor. Bishop William Wilkins, Jr., Assistant Pastor.
You are tuned in to Greater Refuge Temple, the church in the heart of the city, with the people of the city in its heart.
Oh, wonderful. Truly wonderful. It is truly wonderful. What the Lord does. Glory to His name.
Come on, help me say it is
truly wonderful. What the Lord has done.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
It is truly
wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
What the Lord has done.
Lord has done.
Glory to His name.
Glory to His name.
It is truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful. What the Lord has done.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
What the Lord has done. Say glory.
Glory to.
Truly wonderful. Truly wonderful. It is truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
What the Lord.
What the Lord has done.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
What the Lord.
Lord has
say glory to
glory
His name.
To His name.
Say truly wonderful.
Truly wonderful.
Listen, oh, the joy that came to me when I knew that I was free, when my Savior found me, put His arms around me. Oh, the joy, joy, joy that came. Come on, Sandy, help me say, oh.
Oh,
the joy,
that joy
that came to me,
that came to me
when I knew,
when I knew
that I was free,
that I was free,
when my Savior found me, put His arms
around
the
joy.
Blessed Savior, wonderful Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We magnify the Lord today for this Palm Sunday celebration, hallelujah. When we lift our voices before the Lord and we magnify and we praise and glorify His holy name. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We continue in service at this time with our prayer period. We're going to call District Elder Chris Lawrence. No. District Elder Samuel Chris will come at this time. It was a Chris I knew. God bless you. He will come and leave us in prayer. And then following him, we'll have Minister Samuel Sirundi, who will do our scripture in Jesus' name. Elder, district elder, Samuel. Most High God,
hallelujah.
Most High God, Eternal Father, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who is and was and is to come, the Almighty. We bless you this morning. We praise you this morning. We glorify you this morning. We exhort, O God, and extol thy holy and thy righteous name. For you are a holy God. You are a mighty God. You have all power, all authority in your hand, Lord God. Look upon us this morning, Father. Give us a visitation, O God, by the power of your Spirit, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Rain on us this morning, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Pour out, Lord God, your blessings upon us, Father. Move, Lord God, from pew to pew, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Save, heal, deliver, set free, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your glory, Shamahaya, fill this temple, Lord God. Your glory, Lord, fill this temple and save, Lord God. Heal, deliver by the power of your Spirit, Lord God, by the power of your blood. Move upon us, Lord God. Move, Lord God, from person to person, Lord God. Pew to pew, Lord, Shamahaya. In these last and evil days, Lord God, oh Lord, bind our wicked ones, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind it up, Habasiyama, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, hallelujah, we ask your healing this morning, Lord God. Your healing of our bodies, your healing of our spirit, oh God, your healing of our soul, Lord God. We pray that you heal this morning, Father. Selimosia Bahaya, heal this morning, Lord God. I pray, Father, that you touch, Lord God, Minister George Harriet, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, hallelujah. Let your glory go into that room, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ, and heal his body, Lord God. For you are our healer, Lord God. You are our deliverer, Lord God. For you were wounded for our transgressions, O God. You were bruised for our iniquities, Lord God. The chastisement for our peace was upon you, Lord God. And by your stripes, I am asunder. He is healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He is healed. Yes, Lord God. Beverly McNair, Lord God, touch your body, Sabahaya. Loose the tongue, Lord God. Loose the tongue, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord God, you're able.
Yes, Lord God, you're able, Lord. Church, Lord God, hallelujah. Sister Gail Hardy, Lord, by the power of your blood, Lord. Let your blood flow through our very being, Lord God. Shelebokaya Messiah, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Masanda. Missionary Hodge, Lord God, touch a body. Heal a body, Samahiaba. Strengthen a body, Lord. Yes, Lord God. Brother George said, Lord God, touch his body, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, deliver, Father, by the power of your blood, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, we give you all the praise, Lord. We give you all the honor, Lord. Save somebody this day, Lord God. Save somebody this day, Lord God. Yeah, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. For we all are, hallelujah. Hosanna! I am a sinner. Hosanna! Set up a higher. Hosanna! Victory! Praise God! We have the victory. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we give you all the praise, sir. We give you all the honor. Bless your servants this morning. Bless our pastor, Lord God. Hallelujah. Our assistant pastor, bless their wives, their families. Bless all of our families, Lord. Save our whole household, Lord, in these last and evil days, Lord. For we know, Lord God, you are soon to come. Yes, Lord God, but let us be that beacon of light. Let your light shine through us. Let your glory, Father, shine through us, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we will not fail, Lord God, to give you all the honor and all the glory, Father, that you are so worthy of. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thy will be done, Father. Thy will be done. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. While the ushers are seating those that came during the prayers, let us prepare ourselves. You're going to read with me Isaiah chapter 55. Isaiah 55, we're going to read the end. Endure with me to read the entire passage of the scripture in Jesus' name. Isaiah 55. Just read along with me. When you find it, you are acknowledged by the word, amen. Isaiah 55. Ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters, and he that hath no money, come ye, buy and eat. Yea, come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Wherefore do you spend money on for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which satisfies not? Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. Incline your ears and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. Behold, I have given him for a witness to the people, a leader and commander to the people. Behold, thou shalt call a nation that thou knowest not, a nation that knew not thee, shall run unto thee because of the Lord thy God and for the Holy One of Israel, for he hath glorified thee. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, said the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and the bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things whitherto I send it. For ye shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth before you unto the singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the fir tree, and instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle tree, and it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. May the Lord bless the reading of his word and sanctify in our hearts in Jesus' name.
I'll fight your battles.
He
said, if you will only trust. me.
If you will own me.
Whatever it is that you're petitioning for. Let's trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lead not to your own understanding. Trust me. Come on, let's raise it up. Say, I am.
I am.
He's saying, I am that I am.
That I am.
I have all power. Said, I will deliver whatever it is. Whatever I promise you, I will deliver. If you will only trust. Someone lift your hands and just say, Lord, I trust you. Lord, I believe you. Lord, I love you. I give it to you, Jesus. I give it to you. If you will only trust me. Say, trust me. Trust me. Put your trust in Jesus. Though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Say, trust me. If you will only trust me. Say, trust me.
Trust me.
Come on, let me hear you sing it. Say, trust me.
Trust me.
Say, trust me.
Trust me.
If you will only trust me.
If you will only
I am your healer. I am your provider.
Me.
He said, I will do anything.
Trust
I can do the impossible. He said, trust me. If you will only trust me,
if you will only
trust me,
trust me.
Somebody say, trust me,
trust me.
Say, trust me,
trust me.
Last time, if you will only trust me,
if you will only
trust me. Say, in the midst of this, I trust you. No matter what I'm going through, I will only trust you. Say, Lord, I will trust you. And only you. And only you. And only you, Lord Jesus. I will trust you. And I will say yes to your will. And yes to your way. Trust you with all my heart, and I will not lean. I will not lean to my own understanding, but in all my
Bless you. If you will only trust, God promised to fight our battles, lead us from victory on to victory. If we will only trust Him. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord Jesus. At this time, we're going to have Sister Peddler to come forth. Sister Dolores Peddler. With our woman's touch in history. Sister Peddler.
Praise the Lord, everyone, and good morning. March is National Women's History Month, and the Sisterhood Department has presented Marie Van Britten Brown, Home Security System. African American inventor Marie Van Britten Brown contribute to a safer society with her invention of the first home security system. Her invention was the first closed-circuit television security system and paved the way for modern home security systems used today. Brown was born in 1922 in Jamaica, Queens, New York. She started off her career working as a nurse. Her husband, Albert Brown, was an electronics technician. As a nurse, Brown worked long hours and would return home late at night. Her husband, too, had irregular hours. So she was often left alone at night, fearful of being vulnerable in a high crime neighborhood. Brown decided to figure out a way to see who was at her door if she heard knocking. In 1966, Brown, along with the assistance of her husband, invented a security system which consisted of four peepholes, a sliding camera, television monitors, and two-way microphones. These items created a closed-circuit television system for surveillance, also known as CCTV, with multiple peepholes in the sliding camera, was able to capture images of people who were different heights. The two-way microphones allowed Brown to communicate with the person outside. She also had a remote that would allow her to unlock the door at a safer distance. Lastly, she could press an emergency button that would send an alarm to police or security. In 1969, Brown and her husband received a patent for the invention under the U.S. patent number 3,004,082,137. Her invention was recognized in the New York Times, and she received an award from the National Scientist Committee for her work. Brown passed away at the age of 76 in 1999, but her legacy continues. Brown contributed to home security, led her invention to be cited in 32 subsequent patent applications. Her invention formed a system that is still relevant in today's society, with the use in places such as banks, office buildings, and apartment complexes. Marie Van Britten Brown, Women's Touch in History.
Thank you, Sister Pedler, A Woman's Touch in History. We appreciate so very much all of the contributions of the women of our church and women of the world. Women of the world, God gave us assistance. We're not by ourselves in this, the men, the brothers, we know that, and we thank God for a long time. We have known that God said it's not good that man should be alone, right? He has a complement. He has a helpmeet. He has someone to assist him. And together we move forward in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We've come this far together, and we will move beyond this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to the glory and the honor of God. We're going to have Sister Tai Frizzell to come at this time. Special announcement for the youth.
Giving all the praise and the honor and the glory to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to my brothers and sisters in Christ, I say praise ye the Lord. First, we would like to thank you for those who came out on March 16th for our fellowship. It was from the ABYPU, which was headed by Sister Quiesia Jacobs. It was a beautiful success, and we want to thank you guys for all showing up. And we look forward, yes, we look forward to planning more events for the youth department, but we are sitting here requesting for your assistance for our planning for Vacation Bible School. We want to bring that back in July, which is 2 weeks in July, that we're looking for volunteers to help us out with teaching and also just assisting us with the kids. So, and this will be headed by Sister Loria Wack. So if you have any, if you would like to volunteer, please reach out to her or myself or any of the youth council members. Again, we're trying our best to plan something for the youth. So please reach out to us and let us know whether or not you are able to assist us. And this is not just for the missionaries, this is for the ministers as well. We need your help. So please help us out so that we can have a successful Vacation Bible School, and also look forward to other things that we are going to plan, and we will keep you posted on that. God bless you, and we love you.
Thank you, Tai. Planning for our youth activities to bring them back to church and to keep them active, not just doing something, but doing something meaningful for themselves as well as for the other youth. And to the parents of all of our youth, and even those that you see and know in your neighborhood, invite them to church. Invite them to worship and praise the Lord in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that God will bless them in these last and evil days. As for our announcements, on Friday the 29th, Good Friday, we invite you to be a part of our service live here at Greater Refuge Temple in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, starting at 7 p.m. Come out and be blessed of the Lord. We celebrate, hallelujah, the season. And as we remember our Lord's last words from the cross of Calvary, they will be spoken by our and exhorted upon by our ministers and elders of our church. Prayer service will begin at 7 o'clock here in the sanctuary. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come be blessed of the Lord. There'll be anointed singing. And as I said, the presentation of the seven last words of Jesus from the cross, his concern for us and for mankind as he hung up on the cross in the hot sun on that day, he remembered us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's a live service here in the sanctuary, beginning with prayer at 7 p.m. Be blessed of the Lord in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we want you to join the Global Missions Department for the all-night prayer that they will have on the 29th also. It will begin at 11:59 and it will continue until 6 o'clock in the morning. An all-night prayer conducted by our Global Missions Department under the leadership of District Elder Samuel Chris. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and Sister Aman is the Vice President for that group. And then join the Senior Missionary Board on Sunday, April the 7th at 2 p.m. for their monthly service in memory of Mother Dorothy Anderson. It's a missionary service, but it's held also and in honor and remembrance of Mother Dorothy Anderson, who served so very long as the missionary president. And we thank God for her success, and we remember her fondly in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The theme is Echoes from the Field. Echoes from the Field for that service. That's from Luke 10 and 2. And if you need more information, contact our president, Sister Janice Johnson, Missionary Janice Johnson. And also, on your calendars, make note of the fact that Founders Day weekend will take place here at the temple on May the 3rd and Friday, May the 3rd, and also on Saturday, May the 4th. And more information regarding our Founders Day will be coming. We don't want to forget our founders. See, the Apostle Paul said to the Corinthian church, you might have many teachers, but you don't have but one Father. And we remember fondly our Father of the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, Father of the Refuge Church of Christ, and the organization that came out of him. Over 700 churches strong in the country and in the foreign fields. So remember Founders Day, the 3rd and the 4th of May, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The International Congress will be coming soon on the 3rd through the 6th of that's April. That's right around the corner. 3rd to the 6th of April. If you haven't gotten your tickets yet, please do so. Make arrangements for the Congress and also the seminar that will start on that same week in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. For more details about our international meetings, contact our web pages for that in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And then the convention, the 105th convention of the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, will be held from the 24th through the 28th of July. That is in July. It'll be in Orlando, Florida again. We ask that you would check with our website, cooljc.org, to register for the convention if you haven't done so, and be a part of the many enriching and inviting and educational services, inspirational services for the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Support your church locally and support the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ internationally to be blessed of the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Consult your bulletins weekly for announcements relative to our church events and also regarding our international calendar in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And there's another service, I won't mention it now, that'll be coming up. You will hear about it pretty soon. Church of the Lord Jesus Christ has been around for about 105 years. That's a long time. And we thank God we have had only one split of any consequence. But we have been faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ and faithful to the body. And we thank God for the blessings that we have received as a member of this great church organization. So continue to support it. Invite people to church. Someone needs Christ in his last and evil days. Invite them. Come on to the Lord Jesus Christ. Worship us here at Greater Refuge Temple. More individual evangelistic service. Friendship evangelism, inviting those who you know, friends and those you work with and others. Tell them, let's come to church. Let us worship the Lord together at Greater Refuge Temple Church. Let the Lord bless you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. At this time, we're going to prepare for our offering period. Let us prepare to give in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Giving is an act of worship. We worship by giving at this time. Hallelujah. We give to the Lord because it is said in his word, give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together. Running over shall men give into your bosom, for with the same measure that you meet, it shall be measured to you again. You can't beat God's giving, no matter how you try. I can testify this morning that God is good. And hallelujah, he is good. I thank him for his goodness. Hallelujah. And we will celebrate his goodness, hallelujah, even in our service today as we have done previously, and bless his holy name. And we remember that day when they went before him and came after him shouting, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Save, we pray. Hallelujah. And Bishop Wilkins will be talking more about that today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The ministry of our Lord at a very critical time in the history of the nation of Israel. We give to him that same king that they praised 2,000 years ago as he came into Jerusalem. We praise him today. We celebrate him today. And even by giving, and to those who are worshiping with us live stream, we ask that you be a part of this offering. Give to bless the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. God will continue to bless you also in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Hallelujah. The information is on the screen relative to giving. You may give electronically, giving via Giblify, or you may give by just writing a check or money order and sending it to us here at Greater Refuge Temple, 2081 Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Boulevard, New York, New York. 10027. Give and bless the work of the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. And those that are here in the temple, would you at this time take your offerings into your hands as we bless the offerings in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord? O dear God, we come to you with thanksgiving. We bless your name and we praise you for all that you've done for us, how good you have been in our lives. Hallelujah. Allowed our moments to roll on when the enemy tried to stop us, Lord, even to snuff out our lives. You stood there and, hallelujah, told us to live on. Thank you for your goodness. We give back to you for the support of your work here at Greater Refuge Temple and through our outreach in many areas, oh God, where this church works for the maintenance, hallelujah, of the work of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord. Bless these offerings. Bless these gifts of our hands. Bless the gift and bless the giver. We pray and we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the Lord's people say, amen. This is our main offering. Please give as the Lord has blessed you in your tithes and your offerings. Thank you for giving me the Lord bless you for your support of his work here at Greater Refuge Temple. Thank you for giving in Jesus' name. Ushers will seek those who came here during the offering period. And we will have our final selection from our praise team in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our praise team will come to bless us in song. And following the selection by our praise team, the next voice you will hear will be that of our assistant pastor, Bishop William Wilkins, Jr., who will bring us our message today, our Palm Sunday message, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our praise to you.
Praise the Lord again, everybody. Come and clap your hands with us. Palm Sunday, let's have a little church here. Is that all right? stand on your feet with us. Clap your hands. Hallelujah. We came to praise his name this morning. Let's make one thing quiet here. Let's go. Right here comes our Almighty King.
Help us thy name to say.
Help thou almighty King.
Help thou almighty King.
Help us thy name to say.
Help us thy name to say.
We've come to praise.
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 Thy name. Honor.
We come to praise
on this Palm Sunday.
We come to
Holy come the praise.
Here
come the praise.
Anybody came to praise his name? Any redeemed folk in the house come to praise his name? Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. We've come to praise his name. Would you look at somebody and say, I don't know what you come to do. Look on the other side and let them know, I don't know what you've come to do. But I've come to praise his name. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. We've come. We've gathered in this house to worship him. And to praise his name. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shammah. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I got a little song in my spirit that said, let the redeemed say so. Say from the enemy, let the redeemed say so. Say if to sin no more, I worship him and praise him. Jesus, my Lord and King, let the redeemed say so. Hallelujah. Oh, let the redeemed say so. Say from the enemy, let the redeemed say so. Say. Worship him and praise him. Let the redeemed say so. Hallelujah. Come on. Let the redeemed say so. Save from the enemy. Let the redeemed say so. Save to sin no more. I worship him and praise him. Jesus. Jesus, my Lord and King. Let the redeemed say so. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Come on, everybody. Let the redeemed say so. Save from. Let the redeemed say so. Save the sin no more. I worship him. And praise him. Jesus, my Lord and King. Let the redeemed. Hear your church. Let the redeemed.
Let the redeemed say so.
Save from the enemy.
Save from the enemy.
Let the redeemed.
Let the redeemed
say so. Save the sin no more. I worship him and praise him. Jesus, my Lord and King. Let the redeemed.
Let the redeemed say so.
This is a song of our founder. Everybody say, let the redeemed say so. Save from the enemy.
Save from the enemy.
Let the redeemed say so.
Save
to sin no more.
I
worship him and praise him.
He's my Lord and King.
Let the redeemed.
Hallelujah.
Come on, one more time.
Let the redeemed say so. Save from the enemy. Let the redeemed.
Save to sin no more. I worship him and praise him. Jesus, my Lord and King. Let the redeemed. Come on, put your hands together. That's one of the songs of the church. Our founder, former pastor, wrote that song. You need to know it. Let me hear you say it one more time. Y'all sound pretty good. One more time, say it. Let the redeemed say so.
Save from.
Let the redeemed.
Let the redeemed
say so. Save to sin no more. I worship him and praise him. Jesus, my Lord and King. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. Everybody say it. Yeah. Let the redeemed say so.
He is my Lord and King. Let the redeemed say so.
That's ringing.
Oh, let the redeemed say so.
Save from the enemy.
Let the redeemed say so.
I'm saved no more.
I worship him and praise him.
Jesus,
he's my Lord.
Yeah.
no wonder.
One more time.
Oh, he's the great I am.
The everlasting Father, he's the Prince of Peace. Great eternal wonder, holy counselor. Zion's righteous governor, he's the great I am.
Yes, Lord. Oh, hallelujah.
You had some apostolic folks in the house on this morning. I wish I had some folks in the house that still believe it's one Lord. Woo. One faith, one baptism, one God who is in all, who is through all, and in him I move and have my being. Somebody say one way. Jesus. I better lead us along because I'm. Whoa. One way. Yes. Somebody say one way. Somebody say. Alpha and Omega, one way.
One way. Jesus.
Only one way to God, one way.
One way. Jesus.
Father in creation.
One way. Jesus.
Son in redemption, one way. Church among the saints, one way!
One way! Jesus.
All right, we better leave this alone before this turn into a whole nother thing. That is why I'm going to continue. That is why I'm going to the end. That is why I ran into the strong tower, so that I might testify of him. That is why I'm keeping God's commandments. Anybody keeping God's commandments? And I'm striving each and every day. I might stand with all the saints of God, sing and shout and give God praise. Yeah.
He'll break your fetter. I said he'll break your fetter. Oh, yes, Lord. All right, y'all sit down. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Oh, yes, Lord. There's just one way to God. Y'all take your seats. There's just one way to God. Anybody believe there's just one way to God? Baptized in Jesus' name.
All right, Bishop. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
All right. Open your Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 21. We're also going to be looking at Luke's gospel, chapter 19. Oh, Shamaha. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. It shall be like, I'm trying to leave it alone, in the evening time, the path to glory you will surely find. Through the waterway, there is a light today. Baptized in Jesus' name. Oh, young and old, repent of all your sins. You hear that? And the Holy Ghost will enter in the evening time has come. Tis a fact that God in Christ are one. I better leave this alone. But I thank God I'm apostolic. I thank God I know the power of the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm not mad at you if you believe something else. God help you. God bless you.
Go ahead, Bishop.
But I know in whom I believe. Yes, Lord. We come from a rich tapestry of believers. Amen. And I am convinced that what we have is right and what we have is true. We're not perfect, but we are the people of God. Shamaha. Oh, yes, Lord. All right. Yes. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Do we do honor the Spirit of God that is in the house with us and to our pastor? Let's give God a praise for Jesus Christ and our pastor. We praise and thank God for him and our First Lady, Mother Faye Wright. We praise and thank God for you. And certainly to my lovely wife who's here with me on today. She was under the weather last week. But on this week, she and I will be celebrating 25 years of marriage on this coming Wednesday. And I love her now more than I've ever loved her. You really don't love people and really fall in love until you move in with them, until you can weather the storms of sharing money and raising children. See, initially, it's all physical. You know, it's all physical. You know, you. I like the way you comb your hair. See, some of y'all laugh, so I'm gonna leave that right alone. But it's all physical. But in time, amen, as you grow together,
It becomes so much more than physical. It becomes your life partner. And I praise and thank God for Sarah Tatanisha Wilkins. Amen. Pray for us as we pray for you. Let's go to the gospel according to Matthew. We certainly do honor our preachers here, all of our preachers, our district elder. We praise and thank God for our missionary president, missionary Janice, amen, Johnson. We praise and thank God for all the vice presidents, deacons, mothers, amen. Let's give God a praise for our mothers, faithful mothers, Mother Kennan, and amen. We praise and thank God for each and every one of you. Amen. All of our mothers on our mother's board. Amen. We praise and thank God for you. Let's go to the word of the Lord in Matthew chapter number 21. Amen. Father, we ask now that you would touch us and strengthen us today. God, as we declare your word, we ask now, God, that you would bless us and strengthen us. God, as we proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, stand up in us, Holy Spirit. Lord God, we ask that you would move anything that would bind the preacher or the hearer. Lord God, we call upon you, asking you for your help, asking you for your strength. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. So happy to see so many of you. So happy Sister Tracy Collins is with us. Amen. From Texas, she's here. Amen. And so happy to see our sister here with us and all of you who are here. Amen. And all of you who've asked us for prayer, we're praying a special prayer. We called so many, but Sister Rogera Simmons, we're praying for her in the name of Jesus Christ, that the Lord will strengthen her and her family in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Amen. At this time, we will begin reading the word of the Lord in Matthew chapter number 21. We're going to just read a few verses for the sake of time. Beginning at verse number 8, and it reads on this wise, "And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from trees and straws them in the way. And the multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he was come unto Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this? And the multitude said, This is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee." I'm going to also go to Luke's gospel, chapter number 19, beginning at verse number 37. It reads on this wise, "And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, Blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said unto him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. And he answered and said unto them, I tell you, that if these should hold their peace, the stones shall immediately cry out. And when he was come near, he beheld the city and wept over it." And certainly the word of the Lord is blessed. I want to use for a thought on this morning the three words out of Matthew 21, verse number 10, the latter clause, where it asked a question, who is this? And that is the more what I would call traditional
thought on this morning, but I'd like to see if I could stretch you just a little bit on this morning and also use for a thought when they see Jesus as the problem. When they see Jesus as the problem. I knew that that would not grab you immediately, but I wanted to talk to you on this morning. I have been preaching now for this year, makes 32 years of preaching this year, 31, 32 years of preaching this year. And I have preached a lot of services for Palm Sunday. And it never amazes me, however, anytime I open the book to prepare for this occasion, that the Lord reveals to me a new facet of the story. Now, when you think about the story never changes. But it's amazing how we grow in grace and the knowledge of God, and God shows us new things. As you read God's word, he illuminates new areas of his word in you through the word that helps you. As I looked at this text, I first began to think about, you know, the fact that no one likes trouble. As a matter of fact, most of us have tried to spend all of our lives trying to avoid trouble. Especially as African Americans, and even more importantly, as African American men, trouble doesn't show up on our door the way it does with other cultures. Trouble can be a death sentence when it comes to a black man or a black woman or a person of color. Perhaps you may have experienced the fact that when I began to learn how to drive, and my dad was teaching me how to drive, he said, "Son, if you're ever pulled over by the police, man, keep your hand on the wheel. Don't make any moves. Don't do anything sudden. Only move when they give you permission to move. And when you're about to make a move, let them know, is it all right for me to make this move?" That, amen, is the same lesson I've had to teach my own daughter. Learning how to drive as an African-American young woman, and as my son Blake is now beginning to drive, having the same kind of conversations with him. It's amazing because I've seen some other folks that don't necessarily look like us, amen, who talk all kind of ways and yell at the police officers, amen, stuff that would get you and I killed. Seems as if other folks are able to get away with it. Well, that kind of pulls me away from what I'm talking about this morning, but the fact of the matter is that no one wants to be engaged in trouble. But I would like to suggest to you that all trouble is not bad trouble. That there are some needed trouble. Matter of fact, there was a man, a congressman, a longtime civil rights leader, amen, by the name of John Lewis, representative of Georgia. John Lewis used this word of getting in good trouble. He said sometimes it's necessary for us to get into what he called good trouble. Man, he spoke this on a bridge in Selma, Alabama. Amen, as he began to talk about civil rights. Well, it's important for us to understand this as it relates to the context of what we call Palm Sunday. Now, we do call this Palm Sunday And I guess that is our Americanization of what this day is actually called, but it is really referred to as the triumphant entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. And it is important that you understand this from a cultural concept, because many of us don't understand the context in which this happened, and so it's important that we play out the context. So it's important for us to understand that at this point, Jerusalem is being controlled by the Roman Empire, and there is a lot of tension centered around that, a lot of resentment centered around that. And there are individuals who have been put in place to make sure that everything goes well among the Jews that are there in Jerusalem. It's important to understand that the high priest, somebody say high priest. High priest. Yeah, I just said that to make sure you weren't asleep yet. Amen. The high priest had an important role because the high priest, amen, was the spiritual leader, if you will. He had an awesome responsibility, but he was also on the thumb or under the thumb of the Roman Empire. In other words, amen, you can be our preacher, but you're going to do what we say do. You're going to move when we say move. I thank God that we don't go to a church like that. Amen. Where the preacher has to check with the congregation on whether or not I can preach that or not. Whether or not I can have the freedom to move by the power and the presence of God. You've got to be careful, amen, because there are people who will try to put their thumb on you, try to control you through their own manipulations. You know, manipulation, the Bible says, is similar to witchcraft. You've got to be careful of people who are trying to manipulate you to be their puppet. Only move when you say move, when they say move. Only praise God when they say praise God. Only if you see me dance should you dance. No, 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 beloved of God, I praise and thank God. Amen. That God has been too good to me to allow anyone to manipulate me into being their puppet. Amen. I have one God to answer to. Amen. And so the high priest had this awesome responsibility to lead them into worship. You know, he was in charge of all of the spiritual activities. He was in charge of the sacrifices, the rituals, but he was also, most importantly, in charge of the highest day or their holiest day on the Jewish calendar, which is known as the Day of Atonement. Amen. This Day of Atonement, he was responsible for. So the priest was the man, to say the least. But yet, he was under the influence of the Roman Empire, which complicated things because, amen, he had to do what they said. And if he did not do what they said, we'll fire you and even kill you and get another. Can you imagine having to move only when people give you permission to move? That puts you in conflict with God. Put you in conflict with God when you're serving God. Beloved of God, never forget who you're serving. Man, I serve the Lord. You know, that's why Joshua on his dying bed, amen, said to the children of Israel, he said, look, I've come as far as I can go now. Amen. You have to make up in your mind. Are you going to serve the gods of this land? Are you going to serve the gods of your fathers? But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You have to have a made up mind that as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. That's the way I was raised. That's the way I was raised. My mother and father didn't care what you believed. But on Sunday morning, amen, my brothers like to go out and stay out late. Missionary Johnson, amen. And my mother and father made it clear, I don't care how late you stay out. Amen. But when it's time to go to church, everybody in the house is going to church. I know we don't believe that anymore. We've replaced church with basketball and football and, amen, all those other things. And I think in its rightful place, those things are important. I'm not downing those things. But don't forget about God. Amen. And so there was the high priest who had a tremendous responsibility. Man, he had to make sure that everything went well. And so not only was it just the high priest, but you had the Pharisees. You know, they were the religious scholars and leaders who focused on a strict adherence to the Jewish law and tradition. You know, those folks that come to try to tell you you're not praising the Lord the right way. You know, you're not acting the right way. You don't look saved enough. You don't do what we do. You know, and I do believe that what's on the outside will what's on the inside will show up on the outside. I wish I had a witness here. But I also do believe that we grow in grace. You know, that's why somebody wrote a song that said, please be patient with me. Hello, Lights, they don't like me now. God is not through with me yet. I'm still learning some stuff. That's why I, you know, some folks may think I'm light on folks, but I must be honest with you. This is all I know. And every mistake I made it in the house of God. And so I've learned to show grace because I received grace. I learned how to show love because folks love me. And sometimes when you didn't even love yourself. And so it is the Pharisees who are there, and not only do you have the Pharisees, but you have the Sanhedrin, which is this group of 70 who were, along with the high priests, leaders of that day. I'm just trying to set the context for you, if you'll just give me a few more moments. Amen. It is important to understand that the Pharisees, the Sanhedrin, and the high priests are key to what we call Palm Sunday, or the joyful entry of Jesus Christ into Jerusalem. Because this is at a time where it is Passover. Somebody say Passover. That's why you'll see, amen, instead of showing on some channels the crucifixion or the life of Jesus Christ, you'll typically see the Ten Commandments during this time. Because Passover and the resurrection and Easter Sunday walk hand in hand. It's around that same period. And because it was Passover, you had almost 2 million people who came to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. You remember Passover? Passover was that during that time when the plagues, amen, when Pharaoh held the children of Israel captive. And Jesus said to them that I'm going to kill what? The firstborn. And the only way that you will get around that is to do what? Put blood on the door. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. I thank God for the blood. Because it reaches to the highest mountain. And it flows to the lowest valley. What would I
be without the blood of Jesus Christ. I would have been a mess if it wasn't for the blood. I thank God for the blood of Jesus Christ. Not the blood of bullets and goats. But I thank God for the blood. And so this was an important time. This was an important time because, amen, 2 million people are coming to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. And the most important people during Passover would be, number one, who? The high priest. Because he presides over everything. Can you imagine 2 million people coming to hear you preach? 2 million people coming from all over just so that they can be in the presence of the high priest and allow the high priest to go into the holies of holies and allow the high priest to teach them and to share with them. And so this was his moment. But there was also a political pressure that also took place because the Romans made it clear, we don't want no scuff during the Passover. This is challenging because the high priest is in charge. But what he cannot account for is what others will do. So you have groups like the Zealots, which are known as individuals who fought against Rome. They were like those people who are downtown, amen, who are picketing, rightfully so, amen, against the war in Israel and so many other things. That was the context in which this was. And so now Jesus standing by. Yeah, they want everything to go smooth. They want everything to be in place. Beloved of God, I want to suggest to you, amen, that God is not interested in your order. I like when God comes in and messes up a service. I like that kind of stuff. That's my kind of carrying on. I like when the anointing of God is so rich. Until the choir can't sing. Until the preacher can't preach. Until folks are so drunk and slain in the spirit that they're falling on top of each other. I like that kind of church. I know some of you like the kind of church, amen, where you sit up straight. Somebody say, touch your neighbor, you do like this. Came in mad, leave mad. Won't smile at anybody. Then say, people don't like you. Leave that alone. I don't want to hurt nobody's feelings here. They wanted things to go correctly. They didn't want any stuff. But Jesus said, it's time. What better way for Jesus to make his entry than to have an audience of 2 million. What better way for Jesus, amen, to now do what he was reluctant to do all along? You remember when he healed the blind man, told him to go and wash, amen, put mud on his eyes and told him to go and wash. After he got finished with that, he said, look, don't tell anybody. When he, amen, had healed the lame man, after he healed him, he said, now listen, don't tell anybody.
Why? Because my time has not yet come. But now is the time. And I want to take a biblical principle out of the scriptures to help you on this morning. To let you know that there are some people who don't mind you as long as your gifts are hid under them. Y'all hear me? They don't mind as long as you don't get any more, amen, limelight than they do. They don't mind as long as God is not blessing your singing. They don't mind as long as you're on the job and you're there for 25 years and get no promotion just like them. But let God start blessing you. You'll find out who your true friends are. Your true friends should be able to handle God blessing you. I come to tell you, amen, when God starts blessing your life, your friends should be celebrating you. Those, amen, who have your back, they should be celebrating the fact of what God is doing in your life. As I hasten, amen, to the end, let me explain that amen, they wanted things quiet. And here comes Jesus. Now, you need to understand this because according to John now, I should have said this earlier, to really understand the text, you have to harmonize the gospels. And if you've been looking at our Bible study, we've been doing a lot of talking about harmonizing the gospels. You cannot take one gospel and think you're going to get everything about what we call the triumphant entry into Jerusalem. You have to look at all four of the gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, because all of them bring us details that one may have left out. Doesn't mean that one is right or wrong. It just simply means that they're giving it to us from different perspective. But from John's perspective, he sets it up this way. He says that Jesus had just left Bethany, who lived in Bethany, Lazarus' house, where Lazarus had just been risen from the dead. Are you listening to me? And now, Lazarus is walking around. He had raised Lazarus from the dead. Man, the Pharisees, the Sanhedrin, the high priest all had a problem with it. Because this was on the cusp of Passover. See, things are starting to come out of order. They're trying to keep it in place. But here goes Jesus raising Lazarus from the dead, moving things out of place. I want to talk to someone today that God is beginning to shift things out of place. Because when God starts shifting things out of place, people become uncomfortable when God begins to shift you. I need you to get this. I need you to get this because everything was okay. They were cool as long as Lazarus was dead. But how do you explain that Jesus stands in front of a dead man's grave, looked at the dead man's grave and said, "Roll the stone away." Looks into the grave and said, "Lazarus, come forth." The Bible says, here come Lazarus, leaping out of the grave. I don't know who you are, but God is about to turn some things around in your life. God is about to bring some dead things to life in your life. God is about to pull some things out, amen, that's been in the bed, in the grave for a long time, and people said it'll never get up. God is about to stand
in front of your mess and call it forth. And Lazarus comes leaping out of the grave. Now that Lazarus is out of the grave, tells the amen, grave clothes, loose the man. And let him go. I could work that on this morning because that'll preach all by itself, but I don't have enough time. But I come to tell every devil in hell that in 2024, God is going to loose you for some things that the devil has been trying to hold you back with, some things that the enemy have been trying to keep you bound up in. God is going to make it loose you. I dare somebody that believe it to yell out, loose me and let me go. Yeah, talk to your finances and tell your finances to loose you. Talk to your sickness and tell your sickness to loose you. You got to talk to some people and tell them, loose me and let me go. Oh, I got to run, I got to run, I got to run. And now they've got a problem. Because they were trying to keep everything cool, calm, and collective. But how in the world, come here, Jerry. How in the world do you keep everything cool, calm, and collective? When every time you walk around, they see the miracle. Do you keep from praising God where everywhere you go, all they can see is what God has done in your life? How in the world can you keep things calm when every place you go, all they can see is what God has done for you? How in the world? How in the world can they say there is no God when God healed you from cancer? Whew. I wish I had some cancer survivors in here. How in the world can they say there is no God when every time they look at you, they look at somebody who used to be on drugs, who was strung out on drugs. I wish I had some drug users, used to be drug users, that would say, God is great. How in the world? Oh, glory be to God. I gotta run. Shana Masia. Lazarus, every place they went, he was right there. In your own time, look at the Gospel according to John, chapter number 12. Because they declare that the only way to deal with this problem is to kill Lazarus. We need to get things back in order because this Jesus is a problem. He's a problem. What is going on? Jesus is a problem. There are some people who believe. That's why they try to play down what God has done in your life. They try to tell you, amen, there is no God. They try to tell you, keep going down to that church and giving that church anything. Don't be bothered with those people. Amen. Come on back to the party. But every time they look at you, they see what God has done in your life. Let me run to the end. Jesus wants to make a triumphant entry. So he says, go and get a colt, which is a young donkey, and go and get him and bring him to me. He's tied up, but bring him to me. Oh, God. Jenny, I could preach about that donkey if I wanted to. Because there are some people that the devil got you tied up. But God said, I got a need for them. I'm still one of you. I know he's young. I know he's inexperienced. But untie him. Bring him to me. I got a plan for that. I know nobody wants it, but untie it. Jesus said, expected. Here go the devil. No, you can't have him. He belongs to me. The disciple looked at him and said, the Lord has need of him. Oh, glory be to God. I come to tell you that when God desires to use you, can't no devil in hell hold you back when God has a plan for your life. Oh, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go. But this word is in my belly on this morning because I need somebody to know that the problem that the enemy has with you is Jesus. He says, listen, the Lord has need of him. But he said, bring him, because I'm going to use him. How in the world can this young, weak donkey, if you will, hold up the weight of Jesus? It is because when Jesus is in the picture, he carries his own weight. You would have died in your situation, but God carried you through it. Jesus. I said Jesus. Somebody look at somebody and say Jesus. Jesus says, Lord have mercy, I feel like preaching now. Jesus said, amen, I know that he's young and he's inexperienced, but I'm going to use him anyway. Jesus gets on the donkey and he rides the donkey into Jerusalem. The high priest is preaching his good message. Amen, and all of a sudden he starts seeing people leaving out of the door. Lord, have mercy. This is the moment of the year that the high priest and the Pharisees were waiting for. Because, amen, this was their great time to show off all of their great skills. But God, amen, hallelujah. The Bible declares that they started leaving one by one. Where were they going? Somebody said, Jesus is over there. And I come to tell you on this morning that I want to be where Jesus is. I don't want to just be in church over here. I got to be where Jesus is, because where Jesus is, that's where my healing is. Where Jesus is, that's where my deliverance is. Where Jesus is, that's where my million-dollar business is. Somebody say, I want to be where Jesus is. Oh, yeah. And the Bible declares, hallelujah, that they were all there. And now, as they're there, now they see Jesus. Hallelujah. And when they see Jesus, they start yelling and screaming, saying, Hosanna, hallelujah, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, save us. Lord, have mercy. But Jesus wasn't thinking about their need, because his kingdom was not of this world. Hallelujah. But they began to say, blessed, hallelujah, be the Son of David. In other words, Jesus, hallelujah, who came through 40 and two generations, hallelujah, he gets into Jerusalem, and there now in the crowd is the woman with the issue of blood. Hallelujah. And they're looking at her, and you know the Pharisees and those who have that Pharisaic spirit, hallelujah, were saying, be quiet, you're making too much noise. And the woman looked at her, and I can imagine, and she said to them, you don't know my story. I was bleeding, and I was bleeding, and I was in a crowd of people, and I said to myself, if I can just touch but the hem of his garment, I will be made whole. And I touched the hem of his garment, and I was made whole. Lord, have mercy. I believe Peter's mother-in-law was there. And she said, I was sick and couldn't get well, but Jesus touched my body, and now I can tell. I believe that Jairus' daughter was there praising God too. And she said, Lord, have mercy. I was dead. Hallelujah. But now I live. Hallelujah. Anybody in here? People counted you out, but now you live. Look at somebody and high five them and say, but yet I live. Look at somebody else and say, but yet. Can I preach it like I feel it? But yet I live. Lord, have mercy. I believe that blind Bartimaeus was in the crowd, and he said, I don't know what you think about him. All I know that I was blind, but now I see. Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. And you want me to keep my mouth closed. And right next to you are some Pharisees who wish you would sit down and shut up. But I come to tell you on this morning, I've got a reason to praise the Lord. You don't know what I've been through. You don't know what God delivered me from. I should have been dead and gone. Folks counting me out, but I've got a reason to praise the Lord. And if you don't want me to praise him here, I'll get in the aisle and I'll run around this church, because I got a reason to praise the Lord. And if you got a problem with me, it's because you don't know that there's power in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. It was Jesus that healed me. It was Jesus that delivered me. It was Jesus that set me free. Somebody say, it was Jesus. Look at somebody else and say, it was Jesus. I should have been in a Looney Tune someplace. I should have been in a psych ward, but it was Jesus that held my mind together. It was Jesus that healed me from the cancer. It was Jesus who healed me from the fibroid. It was Jesus, and you want me to keep my mouth closed. If I hold my peace. If I hold my peace, the very rocks will cry out. Now there's different translations, and other folks, some say that he was talking about those non-Jews would praise the Lord. But the traditional view is that God will raise up another generation that will stand and that will declare his name. God doesn't need you. God will raise up a drug dealer from 128th Street and bring him in here and let him sit right next to you and praise God. I dare somebody that has a reason to praise the Lord, to give God the best praise you've got. Give him the best praise. You don't know what he's done for me. You don't know what he's done for me. You don't know like I know. You can't tell it, let me tell it. And if anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Tell them I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, and fire baptized, and I'm running. I don't need no stone crying out for me. Anybody have a reason to praise the Lord? Anybody have a reason to give God praise? When God enters the room, I've got to praise him. I don't care if people like it. I've got to praise him. I've got to lift him up. I've got to magnify him. I've got to glorify him because he's been good to me. Oh, hallelujah. If these hold their peace, I will raise up a people that will yet praise him. I want you to know that as good as God has been to you, don't let any system or any person or any situation put its thumb on you and try to make you the problem. You are not the problem. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. They wanted to make Jesus the problem, but they yelled, Hosanna, Hosanna. Now I need to say this before we do the altar call. Those who would like to be baptized, those who would like to be saved, we're gonna make a call for you. But I need you to understand this, that in the crowd, everyone was not calling on Jesus. That's why 7 days later they switched up on him. Or a few days later they switched up on him and started yelling, crucify him, crucify him. Some of them were just there to see a show. They weren't interested in praising Jesus. They were there for the mechanics of things. The Bible even says in John chapter number 12, if you read it, it says some of them were only there to see Lazarus. But yet, there were those who God had made a way out of no way. And said, I know what we're dealing with. But God knows my heart. God knows that I've got a reason. And I don't have time to worry about anybody else. Let the tare and the wheat grow together. And at harvest, God, he will do the separating. God does not need you to do his business. God does not need you to try to pluck out in the church who's saved and who isn't. God said, I know those that are mine. God knows you. You've got a reason to praise the Lord. Don't let anybody bind you. Don't let anybody stop you. As a matter of fact, there's someone here right now that wants to give their life to Jesus. But you're more concerned about the people around you and what people will think and what people will say about you. Some of you have backslidden. Some of you have fallen away from God, and you don't want anyone to know. But I dare you to take courage right now and make your way to this altar. Come on, come on, come on, make your way to the altar. Make your way to the altar. If you're here, you want to be baptized in Jesus' name. This is your time. This is your opportunity. Come on. Come on to Jesus. Come on. Come on. Come on to Jesus. Come on to Jesus. Come on to Jesus. Come on. That's right. Come on. You want God to fill you with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Perhaps you're sick in your body. Perhaps you're challenged by life. Don't leave the way you are. Come on, let God fix it for you. Come on, come on. That's right. That's right. That's right. No matter what you're struggling with, no matter what your challenges are, come on. Come on. Come on. We're going to give the palms out in a few moments. Just come on. Come on from where you are. Come on. Come on. Come on. That's right. Come on. Leave from where you are and make your way down to the altar. Come on. Jesus is the only way. He is the only way. He said, I am the door. I am the light. Come on, come on, come on. That's right. That's right. Look at God. Look at what God is doing. Church, do you see this? Look at what God is doing. He's bringing them from everywhere. It's time to pray, church. It's time to pray, church. Come on, come on, come on. That's right. That's right. Come on, come on, come on, come on down. Don't leave the way you came. Now, preachers, now listen, don't just slap oil on folks and start praying. We're praying and believing God that people are going to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Missionaries, be prepared to work with souls. Come on, come on, come on. This is our time. This is our opportunity. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. One way Jesus
to one fall. Prepare themselves.
become the sons of God.
The sons of God.
Let's do that again. Even though our Lord ascended,
even though our Lord ascended, He promised us a comforter to live in us and give us power to become the sons of God.
Let's sing it together, for there is one way,
or there is one.
There is one way, and Jesus is the way.
There is one way.
One Lord.
say Jesus. Lift your hands and say Jesus. Say Jesus. Call his name. No one like Jesus, Alpha and Omega, Jesus, beginning and the end, Jesus, 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 Jesus. For there is one way,
there is one way,
and Jesus is the way,
and Jesus is the way.
Let me hear you say,
to redemption.
One way, Jesus.
One way, Jesus.
Lift your hands and say, for there is one way.
For there is one way.
There is one way.
There is one way.
And Jesus is the way.
And Jesus is the way. From creation to redemption. One way, Jesus. Still
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. 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 Come on, lift your voice and say, Jesus, Jesus.
If you're here, you'd like to make Refuge Temple your church home. Bishop Charles Wright, Sr., your pastor, this is your opportunity to come. If you need a church home, you can come now. We'd love to have you be a member of this great church. God bless you. Come on.
Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Let your voice and say,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Call him healer, say healer.
Healer, healer, healer. Healer, healer, healer.
He's my
healer.
Call his name, say Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
One more time, say healer.
Healer, healer, healer.
Say healer.
Healer, healer, healer.
Say healer.
Healer, healer, healer.
Call his name, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Call him Savior.
Savior, Savior, Savior.
In the atmosphere, Savior,
Savior, Savior, Savior, Savior, Savior, Savior.
Come on, call his name,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Say, Savior,
Savior, Savior, Savior.
He is my
Savior, Savior, Savior.
Say, Savior,
Savior, Savior.
Call his name, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
With uplifted hands, everybody say, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
We turn you into the hands of our pastor.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Oh, yes, I see.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Last time, say, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Precious, precious heart. At this time, we're going to bless the palms, and you may receive one and take it home with you as a reminder of this great day a day of celebration, a day of triumph for the people of God. Those who accepted Jesus 2,000 years ago, and as we have followed in that same steps. So would you bow your heads and stand with me, please. Everyone, please stand. Please stand. The palms are a symbol of victory, symbol of achievement. Even in the book of Revelation, they wave their palms, leaves, and magnify the Lord for what he had done for them. So when someone asks you about it, if they would see perchance you walking through the streets with your palms, it would be an opportunity for you to testify, tell of the love and the mercy of God, how he came into Jerusalem a long time ago, and he's still coming into the lives of men and women who want him in their lives. So in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, as you invite him, he will come into your lives. He will bless you, give you, hallelujah, even the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Would you bow your heads at this time? Dear God, we come before you with thanksgiving. We bless and we magnify your name. You came according to the scriptures and on time prophetically into the city of Jerusalem 2,000 years ago. And they cried out, Hosanna, we pray. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, we hold up these palm leaves, Lord God, as a symbol of our hallelujah faith and trust in you that is still working 2,000 years later on. Hallelujah. Bless your children, each and every one, Lord God, that shall receive a palm. May they have like faith as they had 2,000 years ago. Let the victory of God, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, come into their lives. Rebuke the powers of darkness. Every contrary force, everything that's not like you, we rebuke it in Jesus' name. And Lord, these palms, a symbol we hold until that time comes that we will see you again in triumph. As you come back into this world to take control, Lord God, bless now these palms that are upon the altar and everyone that will receive one. Their faith will be in you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. We're going to ask that you would come as directed by the ushers coming, hallelujah, orderly so, and receive your palms. Do not ask for a handful of palms. Take the ones, receive the ones that you're given. It's a symbol of the victory you have in your hearts in Jesus Christ, our Savior. And would you just stand still for one moment? We're going to give the benediction so that you might exit if you'd like to. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, dear God, we come before you with thanksgiving. We praise your name and we bless you for all things. Bless your children as they receive these palms. As they leave this place, but certainly not your presence, grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest with us until we meet again through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen and amen.
Your goodness and your mercy.